In the past months, we've all learned a lot about viruses due to the ongoing COVID-19 pandemic. We've all heard about social distancing or flattening the curve, but we are so engaged that we might forget another virus which will soon spread around the world. SARS-CoV-2 has another viral friend, and this friend is a nearly perfect pathogen when it comes to infecting humanity over and over again. We are, of course, talking about the influenza virus. Yeah, right, flu season is coming and things are special this year. You see, we will have an overlap between flu season and the COVID-19 pandemic. And since COVID-19 and flu patients need similar resources in hospitals, our healthcare systems might be challenged. Fortunately, flu shots are available, which might make a lot of people immune against the influenza virus. And this, on the other hand, might limit the spread of the disease. But what precisely are flu shots and how do they work? My name is Gunnar Steinig and today we'll talk about the influenza virus and how flu shots might save numerous lives in the next months. Let's start by talking about the influenza virus. There are two types of influenza virus named type A and type B, which are responsible for the majority of flu cases. We have all suffered from the flu several times throughout our lives. I guess you could say the flu is more persistent than teenagers who try to become famous on TikTok. You get it? They want to become influencers. The flu is characterized by various symptoms, including fever, cough, or runny nose. These symptoms appear quite rapidly and normally disappear after a few days, but can also worsen over time in elderly patients. Flu shots can prevent the influenza virus from making us sick, meaning that we do not show any of these symptoms. But how does it work? In order to answer that question, we need to find out how our immune system works. Every time a virus infects us, it enters a cell and starts to make copies of itself. Here it uses the machineries of the cell to make hundreds and hundreds of particles, which are then released and start to infect other cells. This is the point where we start to feel sick, and at the same time, our immune system recognizes more and more that something is wrong and starts to fight the pathogen. More and more parts of our immune system are activated, our symptoms become better, and we get healthy. This is what happens most of the times if a virus infects our bodies. However, there are some exceptions, including HIV, which now hides inside our bodies and escapes the immune system. Feel free to click on this video afterwards. But the magic of our immune system does not stop here. There are two special types of immune cells called B cells or helper T cells, which help our immune system to have a memory. We call this phenomenon immunological memory, and it means that our immune system is able to recognize viruses if they infect us twice. In principle, it works like this. Once a B or helper T cell has recognized an infected cell, it becomes activated and starts to kill the infected cell. These activated B or helper T cells can also migrate to different parts of our body where they become memory cells. Memory cells can remain in our bodies for years and they become reactivated once the same virus infects our bodies. The cool thing about memory cells is that they produce immune responses very quickly. This means that if we have memory cells which recognize a specific virus and the same virus starts to infect our cells, then it becomes completely eliminated. In this case, we often do not know that the virus has tried to infect us as we do not show any symptoms. Flu shots or flu vaccinations are based on this principle. We inject a deactivated influenza virus into our bodies and then memory cells are produced. If an influenza virus now infects our bodies, it will be immediately recognized and killed by our immune system, meaning that we do not develop the flu. There are different types of vaccines depending on the preparation of the drug. For the influenza virus, two types of flu shots are widely available. In these vaccines, we find weakened or deactivated influenza virus particles. Compared to being infected with the influenza viruses, flu shots do not cause the flu. There are some side effects which might occur, but they are quite rare and include nausea or swellings. You might not think, okay, we've already developed different types of flu vaccines, so why do we need to update them each year? Well, that has to do with a simple fact. Viruses also evolve. As we've already discussed, the majority of flu cases is caused by type A or type B influenza viruses. Both of these virus types have their genetic information within 8 RNA segments. You might remember RNA from school, its structure is similar to DNA, which of course contains our genetic information, but much less stable. The reason why flu vaccines need to be updated each year is that the virus evolves quickly. And two main mechanisms drive the evolution of the influenza virus: antigenic drift or antigenic shift. You might remember these two terms from a previous video where we talked about the origins of SARS-CoV-2, which of course causes COVID-19. But for you, feel free to watch that video afterwards if you want to be able to tell your neighbor that SARS-CoV-2 originated in nature and not from a laboratory. Antigenic drift means that mutations occur while a virus tries to make copies of its genome. Every time a virus infects a cell and duplicates its RNA, it will make some errors, meaning that the RNA molecules become slightly different. This is something very natural. You can think of this the following way. Imagine that you are a monk during the medieval period. Your job now is to make a Bible, meaning that you sit down in your chamber, light a candle for the atmosphere, and start to write down each page of the Bible. However, you are a bit lazy, so you do not check what you write down. You will now have made some mistakes, and if you now make a copy several times, you will have made more and more mistakes. And that's now what happens if we try to make copies of DNA or RNA. Mutations happen all the time, but compared to other viruses, bacteria or animals which have specific proofreading mechanisms which can correct these errors, the influenza virus makes errors on purpose. As a consequence, the influenza virus always evolves, meaning that our immune system is not able to recognize it after a while. The second mechanism which helped the influenza virus to evolve quickly is called antigenic shift. Antigenic shift happens if two related influenza viruses infect the same cell at the same time. So let's say that a bird influenza virus and a human influenza virus somehow get into the same cell. You might remember that the genetic information of influenza viruses is stored in 8 different segments, and those segments can now be freely exchanged between these two different viruses. So now we can get a new virus which contains genetic information of an avian and a human virus. Since no immune system has seen this new virus before, everyone is susceptible and a pandemic can start. And this has happened in the past. Antigenic shifts have caused some of the worst pandemics in the last century, including the Spanish flu in 1918 and the Hong Kong flu in 1968. So the influenza virus changes constantly, and this is the reason why the flu vaccine has to be updated each year. So what about the flu shot 2020? This year's flu shot will make you resistant against 4 circulating influenza viruses. What scientists are doing here is that they monitor which influenza viruses are commonly detected among populations in spring to make a vaccine which might be effective in autumn. Since flu shot production has to start months before flu season, it is hard to estimate how effective this year's shot will be. In some weeks we'll have more data on this since we will have more flu patients, but for now we can try to estimate the efficiency by looking at laboratory data. Each week scientists are collecting patient samples in order to analyze circulating viruses, and right now it seems like the flu shot might be effective in 2020. So what if you want to get a flu shot? This year you should get your flu shot in September or October. Very young children under the age of 6 months and people with medical conditions are advised against getting a flu shot, but everyone else can and should get the flu shot in 2020. In this manner we will have the chance of getting herd immunity and save numerous lives. So I hope that you enjoyed this episode, and if you did, feel free to leave a like and a comment with your best science pun, and maybe it will get viral. Otherwise, subscribe if you're new here and hit the bell button in order to stay informed about the latest discoveries in life science. And with that, I'll see ya.